If you're a new parent, is your baby sleeping through the night or waking up constantly? What about your kids, the young ones? Well, there's a new study out of Britain that suggests that some sleep problems among babies and young children can be linked to mental disorders in adolescence. Joining me to discuss this is Dr. Joseph Ogile, founder, CEO, and medical director of the Clayton Sleep Institute. Good morning, Joe.
Good morning, John. How are you?
Fantastic. Getting sleep, that's important. But now we're hearing that if the little ones don't get it, it can lead to these problems. Do you hold by this study?
Yeah, I think it's an interesting study. First of all, it's substantial. 14,000 people were followed. They gave them questionnaires over 30 years. So this is a study of risk. It's not a definitive study to say that one causes the other. So we want to caution people. This is helpful information, but people shouldn't be fearful either. So it's a chance to focus on healthy sleep at an earlier age. So this study found that in as early as 6 months, 18 months, and 3.5 years of age, children who had multiple disruptions during the night, poor sleep ability to get to sleep and stay asleep, over time, it was a risk factor for psychiatric disease like personality disorder. So it raises the issue that maybe we can start to intervene at those ages to help with sleep health and potentially change these risk factors.
So this sleep issue that the young ones are having, is this because of their environment or is this something physiologically wrong?
Ooh, John, that's a great question. And this study did not necessarily fully address that. So the environmental issues, since it was a questionnaire study, so the parents were filling out questionnaires and sending them back, whether it was environmental or biological, that's still to be determined. We can't necessarily control the biological part of that. We know some psychiatric disease is clearly related to biological factors, but we can start to influence the environmental issues. And so this is a call to action to start to look at those factors for us and to share that information with our fellow viewers and neighbors who have children of these ages and can potentially intervene with better sleep tactics.
So let's talk about some of those. How can we help the babies and the young kids sleep through the night?
So structure becomes the key issue. Once you strip away the issues of course, hunger, having the children fed, bathed, clothed, the things that you and I would normally do as parents. But now you have the structural issues, which is having a fixed bedtime for the children and a bedtime that's typically reasonable. Young children, especially the ages we're talking about, 6 months, 18 months, 3 years of age, are going to need an earlier bedtime. And we need to develop the habits around that, the disciplines to get those to get the children to bed at that time. And then a consistent wake time, allowing for them to get enough sleep. Those little children need more total sleep time per day than we do. So we need to allow the structure for that. In modern world, of course, the lockdown here has been a bit artificial. But in the modern world, there's many two-parent working families that create an issue for that structure being viable. So we have to try to put things in place that will help support that.
All good advice, Dr. Ogile. Thank you so much for joining us.
John, it's great to see you.
You too. And if you want to get more information and a link to this study, we have it all at fox2now.com and also the Fox 2 mobile app.